Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to episode 15 of The Last of Us Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, we were in the middle of a giant brawl inside this bookstore. So now let's continue with Chapter 5-2, Alone and Forsaken. He had a Molotov cocktail. Thanks for the heads up, Ellie. He was about to do it. He was about to fuck me up. Oh, no, you don't! You little piece of shit.
Oh, shit.
You shoot that green shit at me? Oh, nasty. There's a bunch of guys in this area, huh? I probably would have been better off with the stealth approach, but I just kind of went in, fists a-swinging. Now I'm kind of facing them all at once. Which is probably not the best strategy, certainly not on higher difficulties, but on easy I can just kind of handle it. And it will certainly go a little quicker and be a little bit more fun. I mean, I think we can all agree, going the stealth route is, you know, there's a certain amount of difficulty and enjoyment when you pull it off correctly, but it's also slow and it can be boring. It's kind of like, come on, let's just do it already. Abandoned zone note, let's take a look. Colonel McKenzie, Atlanta QZ, going on 14 months, and this little revolution has turned into a bloodbath. We've lost too many men, and frankly, we're about to lose the entire zone. If we stay any longer, we'll all get lynched. Awaiting your orders, Captain Mastros. So there's QZs, it seems like, in a lot of the big metropolitan areas. Where are these guys? Where are they? Let's head upstairs. If they're up there, whatever. If they're not, whatever. Usually Joel will say something to the effect of, "Okay, that's it," when you kill the last one.
Where is this guy?
Piece of shit. Bingo! Nobody heard that. Nobody heard that. Okay, everybody heard that. Everybody heard that! Yes! Right in the fucking neck. I wish I had more arrows. Whoa! Little prick still alive. Where are you? Poke your head out. Who's that? This guy? You want some of this? Night, night. Bum rush you. I'm not gonna bum rush you. It's not working. Now I'm gonna bum rush your corpse. You're still alive? Thanks, Ellie.
Oh my god!
Those two that close.
To the edge of the universe and back. Endure and survive.
What?
Excuse me?
Savage Starlight.
Comic book?
I've been reading.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the hero says after a big battle.
Endure and survive.
It's a decent motto.
Okay.
Reminds me of my friend Riley's tattoo on his back. Adapt and overcome. Endure and survive. Never give up, never surrender. You know, all the same bullshit. Which is to say, not bullshit. It's actually, as far as life mottos go, endure and survive is pretty apropos in a post-apocalyptic zombie hellhole. I'm gonna reinforce that. Make myself a shivy. A little shivy. Another health upgrade.
Oh, so you're a reader, huh?
Well, I'm not running away from hunters and infected. Yeah, I read all the time.
So, I think maybe you can tell me a joke? I'd like to hear a joke, Ellie. I'd really like to hear a joke right now. Fine. Don't tell any jokes. I know there's a joke in this section. We just kind of have to wait for her to wake up and tell us. We seem to be in some sort of either huge bookstore or, okay. Library.
Time to lighten the mood.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, let's have some jokes. I could use it after that bloodbath.
Bakers trade bread recipes on a need-to-know basis.
Ha ha ha!
Need.
I get it.
A moon rock tastes better than an earthly rock because it's meteor.
It's a little easier to get these with the subtitles, as they really spell out the pun for you.
A backwards poet writes in verse.
Do you even get that?
Of course not. I used to be addicted to soap, but I'm clean now.
All right, I've actually never heard that one.
Okay, I'm all joked out. Now what?
Now we have a secret... I love Ellie's little whispering and humming and... All these cute little things in the background add a lot to her character. But let's shiv this door open and... Get in here. Is there a way to change the brightness from flickering? Maybe it's just my TV. It seems like the brightness is flickering on and off, and I do not like it. My weapon is a little bit stronger. I'm going to keep it. We have an artifact here, a lost areas map. Let's take a look at it. Ooh, no survivors, liberated. Overrun, overrun, overrun. Huh. Any more bow and arrows? Ooh, 50 parts? Nice. Yeah, whatever, I picked it up. I just reinforced it, but I'm gonna get rid of it. I think I'd rather have 9 full hits than 1 lethal hit and 4 sub hits. I feel like the combo I have now is gonna be a little bit more effective. Alright, Ellie, I haven't explored everything in this area yet, but I know I have all the artifacts, so I feel like that's as good as, a good amount of any, to move on to the next section, you know? I feel like we can look and look and look for everything and every little upgrade, but I feel like as long as I have the major artifacts and the things that count towards the trophy, it's probably okay to move on. I actually lost health for that jump. So where are we now? Coming, Ellie? I'm gonna go sift through the trash and look for Oscar the Grouch over here. That son of a bitch owes me money.
Man, you gotta be crazy to string up soldiers.
You get people desperate enough, they'll do just about anything.
And the people that rose up, they're the ones we've been fighting here?
That'd be my bet.
Like, nobody's really the enemy. It's weird. Like, I can understand all the positions. Which makes it kind of a conflict of interest, just... When you have to kill so many of them. It's like, well, they're just kind of defending their territory, and... I understand why they're doing that, and...
Watch yourself on these drops!
You know, they're not necessarily bad people, it's just... They've kind of been put in an impossible situation, just as we have, and... Quite frankly, Joel is just as bad of a character as anybody else in this game. We've killed dozens of innocent people over the course of this adventure. And he's supposed to be, you know, quote, the good guy.
Down.
Let's get out of here.
There's more of them. All right. I don't think they saw us.
No, they definitely didn't see us, because they weren't looking for us.
There's our bridge. We're a little closer. I think.
Let's keep at it. Come on.
Let's explore this area over here where it says death to freedom. Oh, wait, no. Sorry, death for freedom. Completely different thing. Completely different.
That girl is so skinny.
The one on the map over there? The billboard? Yeah, I'd hit it.
I thought you had plenty of food in your time.
Oh, we did. Some just chose not to eat it.
Why the hell not?
For looks.
That's stupid.
Yeah, a lot of us think so too. Alright, now I know there's another Ellie joke book stand-up comedy special slated for the downtown Pittsburgh area, so let's hang tight and wait for her to walk around this area and wear herself out, and then whip out the joke book.
Ready for a joke?
Yes. I've been waiting patiently.
3.14% of sailors are pirates.
Haha.
3.14.
I stayed up all night wondering where the sun went. Then it dawned on me.
Oh, I get it.
What did the mermaid wear to her math class?
What?
An algebra.
Terrible.
Why did the scarecrow get a promotion?
All right.
Because he was outstanding in his field.
That'll do. Put that thing away.
That's it. That's all I got.
You keep saying that's all I got, but you keep taking the book out and reading more, so clearly that's not all you have. So we have to go over here to the hotel where we saw those guys. But first, let's take a detour and check out this red X. Use the shiv to unlock the Regal Apartments. Any infected in here? Any infected? Come out, come out. Have an artifact. Mother's letter. Let's take a read. My son, my little boy, I buried him today. What did he do? Join a protest? Now they're labeling him as a traitor. Fine. I'll show them what a traitor does. I've joined them. The rebels. The riders. They gave me a gun, some bullets, and a mission. I won't survive this, but neither will they. How many other fathers and mothers like me are out there? It's only a matter of time before the city falls. Let's go knock out the first brick. Eva. Interesting. Even the moms are up in arms.
No one wins.
Yeah, exactly. No one wins. Kind of a dog-eat-dog world, eye for an eye. Makes the whole world see a lot poorer. I'm not good with idioms. Oh, what's this? Oh, just a rag. I thought it was another artifact. They kind of look the same. All right, well, we picked up a lot of good stuff in the Red X store at the Regal Apartments. I think now it's time to, Savage Starlight! That's the comic she's reading! There's billboards for that, too. That's cool.
I can't make that jump.
If you get me up there, I can move that plank.
Great, so I need to find another wood pallet. And it's way over there. Oh, I hate swimming in this green, shitty water.
Wait here!
Let's see where this goes.
See, if this was Nate Drake, you could just climb up on that bus with no problem.
What the hell? Oh, this place is bad.
What is that screaming I hear? Car comes to a grinding halt, then the next thing you hear is just people screaming. That's a wonderful sight.
What was that all about?
Get on. We're coming through the hotel.
Come on, Ellie. Get on the fucking piece of wood.
Okay.
I don't know why we have to cut through the hotel. I feel like we always take the path of most resistance. Did you get on the stupid bus? There, get on the bus. She's gonna put the plank across, but I have to get to the top of this thing still.
Set up that plank like they did.
Oh, wow. It was a whole area in here. Nice. It's like an old coffee shop. It's because it is, asshole. You don't have to be mean. Working on it. I'm just looting through this coffee store here. Full. I can bind some stuff, right? I can buy some, build some more smoke bombs. We now have all of the items unlocked. We don't have all of the guns yet. I think there's one or two guns left. But we do have all of the items that we can throw and toss.
Stinks.
Eh, wood's all rotten.
Did you go to coffee shops a lot?
I did.
And what would you get?
Just coffee.
What was a missing line from that dialogue? Again, I'm curious as to why there's inconsistencies. The subtitle said, I did, all the time, but we never actually heard Joel say that, which is... Oh, it's weird. Nothing wrong with it, just kind of, definitely intrigues me. What do we got over here? Any comic books in this coffee shop? Got some more crap up on these shelves, though, so that's cool. Oh yeah, that's it. Put it in my dumper. That's what I nicknamed my backpack. Another shiv and a stash note. It goes down tonight. We're going to take down the eastern checkpoints. I've stashed some extra supplies at the Regal Apartments. I've marked with a red X. Hey, we've already been there. Just hop down here. And then hop up on top of this thing. No, no, Joel. Pay attention. We're going across this thing. Come on, Ellie. Let's go to the next level. The hotel. The Hotel Grand, is that what it's called?
Do you think those hunters are gone?
No.
Find out.
No, I do not. If I were to live anywhere in a post-apocalyptic zombie hellhole, it would probably be a Walmart or a Home Depot first. But then, very fancy hotel because they'd have the best accommodations and be decently easy to secure and defend.
You ever stayed at a place like this? Before it all went to shit, I mean?
No. No, this is too rich for my blood.
A coffee machine! That L3 look in this direction prompt doesn't always work. Sometimes there's walls in the way, and I think maybe it'd be cool if the game had enough sense to like swing around and show you from a wide shot. It doesn't though. So I don't know. You're stuck with it. We'll deduct another point. Last of Us, I think, is down to 996 points now out of 1,000. Well, it still gets an A+. I'm going to put the ladder here first, because I saw some goodies up on top of the scaffolding. What do we got here? Ooh, some bats. Super. Pick up the ladder again. I'm going to put it right over here. Hard hat area. Ladder seems a little steep, but it'll do.
Come on up.
I wish I could get my flashlight attached to my backpack like that. I always have to use it and hold onto it with my grubby little hands. A couple more elevators over here. Note in a suitcase. Note to staff. Let's take a read. To all staff, the combination for the security safe for hotel guests' valuables has been changed to 22-10-56. You want to bet the safe is over here behind the front desk? That's the safe, all right. Concierge. Walk around the desk here and see what's in the safe. I bet it's something good. Something tells me I'm into something good. Let's open up the safe. Explosives. Wow, 50 pats. A training manual. Shivs upgraded. They now last 2 times longer. Great. Improving the durability of blade can be important when replacements are unavailable or in short supply. Cool. I like all these little brochures and maps over here. You know, for the local Pittsburgh attractions. Like Pittsburgh has any attractions. Ha ha, ha ha. All right, before we go meet up with Ellie up on the elevator bank, I want to actually take a look at the training manual. We've never actually bothered to read one of them before. We've read the tip. But if you actually zoom in, you can see how it actually works. And it mentions here, binding, a rigid object can be bound as a splint. Flip it over. Stealth combat weapons and tactical movement. Department of Defense, August 2010. That's kind of cool. Little details like that, always fun. What's up, Ellie? Oh, no, no, put it back, put it back. Trying to climb it. Not hold on to it. Stupid fool. So what's up? Anything you want to tell me?
Okay. We need to lighten the mood. Ready?
I'm set. Let's do
it.
It
doesn't matter how much you push the envelope, it'll still be stationary.
We heard this one.
What is that?
It's a joke book. No pun intended. Volume 2 by Will Livingston.
Let's keep going.
I tried to catch some fog earlier. I missed.
Cringeworthy.
Do you know what's not right?
Left?
Yeah. That's awesome. What does a pirate say while eating sushi?
I don't know what.
Ahoy! Pass me some soy.
That's not that good. I don't like that one.
I don't get it. People are making apocalypse jokes like there's no tomorrow.
Ooh. That one hit close to home.
Too soon. All right, I'm done. For now.
All right, Ellie, let's go upstairs. A majority of the joke book unlockables, if you want to call them that, are in the first couple chapters of Pittsburgh. We've already done 4 out of 5. There's only one more of those little joke things. So they're all bunched together in one section of the game, which I guess makes sense. I feel like if they had spun those out evenly, it would have felt kind of weird. Unfortunately, time is up on another episode of Game Time, but stay tuned for the next installment of The Last of Us Let's Play, where Joel ventures deeper into the Hotel Pennsylvania and discovers some creepy things in the basement. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.